recording!
Hey, moron!
Tell me what.
Go ahead.
Are you filming?
Probably poop with my lips.
You're gonna lick it. I'm telling you, man, she'll lick it. Lick it, cow, lick it.
Standing there holding
it, one of the toes. Come your face. And now another crazy wild now.
I can do that.
From my sidekick, Christian Elton.
Wait, you're not pointing at me, dude.
It's got the snow.
Are you filming it?
Yep.
And now another wild, crazy, and outlandish news update from my sidekick, Christian Elton.
Do you like to read?
I do not like that one. No.
Even if you don't, you should read your scriptures. Because they're a good thing to read. And this year in seminary, we're going to be keeping track of your log. And you're going to have a log. And then if you finish your log, you're going to get a certificate. You'll have the logs today, don't worry. I don't have one to show you, but they keep track of what you've read and what you're going to read. And, okay, that's all I have to say.
Stupid.
Well, what's new? Anything?
We're just filming a video for seminary.
Oh, I see. Pick it up here.
Filming
day off, huh?
The cows.
Videos of cows.
Hey, moron!
Go ahead.
And now another wild, crazy, and outlandish news update from my sidekick, Kristen Nugent.
Be afraid of that one.
Do you like to read?
I do not like that one. No.
Even if you don't, you should read your scriptures. Because they're a good thing to read. And this year in seminary, we're going to be keeping track of your log. And you're going to have a log. And then if you finish your log, you're going to get a certificate. You'll have the logs today, don't worry. I don't have one to show you, but they keep track of what you've read and what you're going to read. And, okay, that's all I have to say.
Okay, welcome to seminary. This year, you will have received, or you will receive, a certificate. These certificates, on the top it has a reading log type thing that you will be able to keep track of what you have read, and it will be a monthly basis. Down here is for your scripture masteries. Once you've passed one off to your teacher or your parent or a trusted person, then you can get a sticker and go ahead and stick one on here from your teacher. Here is the memorizing of the Brethren and the books of the Book of Mormon. And you will be able, once you finish this, you will receive a signature from the principal and from your teacher. And when you finish something, you'll receive a sticker to put on there, as so. Oops. And so once you get it filled up, it will also be used as your seminary card, and so you'll know if you let her. So come unto Christ, you're reading your scriptures.
The problem is when I'm throwing you, I think it's going to find out that dot.
Just go up and hit it!
Trigger! Pull the trigger!
Oh! Okay, who is it?
Oh, so cute!
Oh, come on. Oh, God. He's your father, Christ.
It had to know it was coming. I got this.
You guys gotta watch the cheer.
Hit him in the head with the board.
Been
practicing. He wants a pitcher.
One shot.
Come on, Peter.
Back up the
wall. What is that? Thank you.
That's not funny.
Oh.
I do.
Persuade them to punch.
Yeah, go ahead.
Excuse me. Just for the record. Oh!
Who won? You're gonna start.
Okay.
Good. Put me in, good. I'm ready.
I want you to go over there and sit down for a while.
Good, I'm ready. Put me in, coach.
Yep. Go sit down for a while.
Coach, put me in, coach. I'm ready, coach.
All right. Look, take this ball. When you get in the game, I want you to run for a touchdown.
Okay, coach. I will go and do the things which thou hast commanded. For I know that the giving all commandments unto me, save you shall prepare a way I can accomplish them. Thank you, coach.
Oh my gosh, that was stupid.
Put me in, coach. I'm ready.
I want you to go over there and sit down for a while.
Okay. Coach, I'm ready. Put me in, coach.
Yep. Go sit down for a while.
All right.
Look, take this ball. When you get in the game, I want you to run for a touchdown.
Okay, coach. I will go and do the things which thou hast commanded. For I know that the giving all commandments unto me, save you shall prepare a way I can accomplish them. Thank you, coach.
For the next few weeks, we are going to play scripture football. Your class will be competing against the other classes to see how many total yards and touchdowns you can achieve. In a few days, you will see a football field on the wall in the hall of the seminary building with your class team on it. What you must do to score points is read every day. It's as easy as that. If 50% of your class reads, you move 10 yards, 60% 20 yards, 70% 30 yards, 80% 40 yards, 90% 50 yards, and if your class reads 100% for the week, you get a touchdown. So encourage your classmates to read every day, and always remember, the reward is reading.
left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Hey! Out of line. Drop him, give me 20.
Being obedient can save your life.
Okay. Please come to the attendance office.
This year, and we got that, didn't we?
Yeah.
Okay, you're gonna edit it out. This year, month in seminary, this month in seminary, we've decided to help you come unto Christ through being obedient. We will give you a list of 14 things that you will complete each day over a span of 2 weeks, including Saturday and Sunday. Once you come to class the next day, your class president will take the count of how many of you have done the thing. And at the end of the 2 weeks, whichever class has been the most obedient will get a wonderful prize. Good luck.
Left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right, left. Hey! Out of line. Drop him, give me 20.
Being obedient can save your life.
This month in seminary, we've decided to help you come unto Christ through being obedient. We will give you a list of 14 things that you will complete each day over a span of 2 weeks, including Saturday and Sunday. Once you come to class the next day, your class president will take the count of how many of you have done the thing. And at the end of the 2 weeks, whichever class has been the most obedient will get a wonderful prize. Good luck.
There you go.
Therefore he did say no more to the other multitude, but he stretched forth his hand and cried unto those whom he beheld, and were truly penitent. And he said unto them, And I beheld that ye are lowly in heart, and if so, blessed are ye. Behold, thy brother hath said, What shall we do? For ye are cast out of the synagogues, that ye cannot worship our God. Behold, I say unto you, do you suppose that you cannot worship God, save it be in your synagogues only? Tell me what.
Okay.
And moreover, I would ask you, do you suppose that you must not worship God only once a week? Stop that! This is for your profit and learning! Therefore he did say no more to the other multitude, but he stretched forth his hand and cried unto those whom he beheld, and were truly penitent. And he said unto them, And I beheld that ye are lowly in heart, and if so, blessed are ye. Behold, thy brother hath said, What shall we do? For ye are cast out of the synagogues, that ye cannot worship our God. Behold, I say unto you, do you suppose that ye cannot worship God, save it be in your synagogues only? And moreover, I would ask you, do you suppose that ye must not worship God only once a week? Stop that! This is for your profit and learning!
Ah! Look at those socks!
Yeah, right now.
Alright, I think it takes away the spirit when people are tardy to seminary. I think it takes away the spirit when people are tardy to seminary.
Here you go.
I think it's very disrespectful to you, my dear seminary teacher.
Hey.
I think it's disrespectful to the class, too.
Here you go.
I think it's disrespectful to the class, too. I think it's disrespectful to the I think it's disrespectful to the
Okay.
I think it's disrespectful to the class too. Huh?
Okay.
It makes me so mad I want to spit.
Or film a nail? I'll bet people who are tired even have more than one earring, too.
They probably even have a tattoo.
With enthusiasm, with emotion. Like you're ready to cry.
Alright. How could anyone feel good about themselves when they're tardy?
These people need our help!
Do you want the,
How can we teach them the principle and freedom that comes from obedience?
That's it! Obedience equals freedom. Disobedience, captivity.
Wait. Start over, wait. I think we should be tardy for some
Try.
I think I'm gonna be tardy for seminar today. I think I'm gonna be tardy today. It's only seminary.
Yeah.
Let's be tardy for seminary today. It's just seminary.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna be tardy today. It's only seminary.
Yeah.
Hey, tardy boys, you're falling into captivity. Don't you understand that freedom comes from obedience and your tardiness is... Crap! What is it? Hey, tardy boys, you're falling into captivity. Don't you understand that freedom comes from obedience and your tardiness is leading you captive? Please change.
Okay!
Yeah!
Okay. Okay. Okay.
Class, we need to talk about a challenge we have here in seminary today. It has to do with tardies. It's really, really serious. Being late to class is a big deal, and it really matters.
What?
Okay. Action!
How was mine?
Man, I hate that Paul Colton kid.
He
thinks he knows everything. He just keeps on talking.
Did you,
Man, I'm sick of Paul. He drives me nuts. Everybody in class is like, man,
I can't stand
him. Yeah, bugs me so much. Did you, finish your,
Fall brings joy, so they have to be, like, laughing.
Well, they will after me.
No. Yeah, that's why we're really laughing. Oh, he's
like... Oh.
Chris Long is. Come to the Morningside Wednesday, November 14th at 10 minutes to 7 o'clock. If you want to know who Chris Long is and what her great message is, come to the Morningside on Wednesday, November 14th at 10 minutes to 7 o'clock.
Who do you think Chris Long is?
Isn't that the famous one-armed harp player?
Who do you guys think Chris Long is?
Oh, he's that famous world soccer player.
Not a soccer player. I thought she was a seminary teacher.
What? It's not a she. It's
yeah,
a
it's a girl.
Chris Long. Chris.
It's a girl. She teaches seminary. Chris. It's a girl.
Who do you think Chris Long is?
Yeah, I know Chris Long. He's the inventor of the first automobile. No, she is not. She's the first woman astronaut. Woman astronaut? What are you, crazy?
I think I'm going to be tardy today. It's only seminary.
Yeah.
Class, we need to talk about a challenge we have here in seminary today. It has to do with tardies. It's really, really serious. Being late to class is a big deal, and it really matters.
I think it takes away the spirit when people are tardy to seminary.
I think it's very disrespectful to you, my dear seminary teacher.
I think it's disrespectful to the class, too.
It makes me so mad, I want to spit.
I'll bet people who are tardy even have more than one earring, too.
They probably even have a tattoo.
How could anyone feel good about themselves when they're tardy?
These people need our help!
How can we teach them the principle and freedom that comes from obedience?
That's it! Obedience equals freedom. Disobedience, captivity.
Hey, tardy boys, you're falling into captivity. Don't you understand that freedom comes from obedience and your tardiness is leading you captive? Please change.
Okay.
How was
mine?
Man, I hate that Paul Colton kid.
Even in class, he's like, man,
I can't stand
him.
Bugs me so much.
Did you,
Who do you think Chris Long is?
Isn't that the famous one-armed harp player?
Who do you guys think Chris Long is?
Oh, he's that famous world soccer player.
Not a soccer player. I thought she was a seminary teacher.
What? It's not a she. It's
yeah,
a
it is. It's a girl.
Chris Long. Chris.
It's a girl. She teaches seminary. Chris. It's a girl.
Who do you think Chris Long is?
Yeah, I know Chris Long. He's the inventor of the first automobile. No, she is not. She's the first woman astronaut. Woman astronaut? What are you, crazy? Oh!
If you want to know who Chris Long is, come to the morning side Wednesday, November 14th at 10 minutes to 7 o'clock.
The greatest gift we have received is the Atonement. Remember Christ this Christmas season by serving others. Hey.
My testimony of the Atonement is that Jesus Christ, because he was perfect, was the only one that could bleed and die to save us from our sins. And I'm very grateful for this because it's the only way that we can go back to him. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
The words of Bruce R. McConkie, which state, "I believe in Christ," echo my testimony. I know that God lives, and that his Son, Jesus Christ, my Savior, died and suffered the most grueling death for me and for all mankind. That love has made me the person I am today. I say that in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
I know that Jesus Christ is my Savior, and what he has done for me through the Atonement helps me throughout my daily life and for my life eternal. And that's it. I know that Jesus Christ is my Savior, and what he has done for me through the Atonement has helped me throughout my daily life and can help all of you if you repent and try to become more like him. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
The Atonement of Jesus Christ is the most sacred and blessed gift we could have ever received. The Atonement to me makes me be more grateful every day of my life to know that someone died and suffered for me so that I could come and live with him again. I'm so very thankful for Jesus, for all he did for me, and I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
The Atonement is the greatest gift that we've ever been blessed with as God's children, and I can't even comprehend it, but I learned to appreciate it more and more by studying it, and it's changed my life so much that I'm a completely different person all the time. I'm always changing and becoming better, and I'm so thankful that I had an older brother who was strong enough and perfect enough to die for me and for all of us. I know that there's no way to repay Christ for the wonderful gift that he's given me in the atonement, but I hope that I use his gift as he's intended me to, and that I will be able to return to him and my Heavenly Father. And these things I say in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Jesus Christ, the very Son of God, atone for my sins so that I might be forgiven. I am very grateful that he was willing to do that. And for everyone else, he was willing to suffer many, many afflictions so that we all might be able to return to live with him again. And he did that so that we could repent and be able to change our lives so that we would become better people and become more Christ-like. And so that is why Christ has asked us to serve others, because when we serve others, we are serving Christ. I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ, amen. The greatest gift we have received is the atonement. Remember Christ this Christmas season by serving others.
I know that Jesus Christ is my Savior, and what he has done for me through the atonement has helped me throughout my daily life and can help all of you if you repent and try to become more like him. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
The words of Bruce R. McConkie, which state, "I believe in Christ," echo my testimony. I know that God lives, and that his Son, Jesus Christ, my Savior, died and suffered the most grueling death for me and for all mankind. That love has made me the person I am today. I say that in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
My testimony of the atonement is that Jesus Christ, because he was perfect, was the only one that could bleed and die to save us from our sins. And I'm very grateful for this because it's the only way that we can go back to him. I say this in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
The atonement of Jesus Christ is the most sacred and blessed gift we could have ever received. The atonement to me makes me be more grateful every day of my life to know that someone died and suffered for me so that I could come and live with him again. I am so very thankful for Jesus, for all he did for me, and I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
The atonement is the greatest gift that we've ever been blessed with as God's children, and I can't even comprehend it, but I learned to appreciate it more and more by studying it, and it's changed my life so much that I'm a completely different person all the time. I'm always changing and becoming better, and I'm so thankful that I had an older brother who was strong enough and perfect enough to die for me and for all of us. I know that there's no way to repay Christ for the wonderful gift that he's given me in the atonement, but I hope that I use his gift as he's intended me to, and that I will be able to return to him and my Heavenly Father. And these things I say in the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Jesus Christ, the very Son of God, atone for my sins so that I might be forgiven. I am very grateful that he was willing to do that. And for everyone else, he was willing to suffer many, many afflictions so that we all might be able to return to live with him again. And he did that so that we could repent and be able to change our lives so that we would become better people and become more Christ-like. And so that is why Christ has asked us to serve others, because when we serve others, we are serving Christ. I say these things in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.